Hi guys, I hope you can all hear me and see me very well. First of all, I want to tell you that and ask you nicely to be gentle with me. It's like my first presentation and sharing the experience and all what I think about the wedding industry and how I deal with the wedding day and tips and tricks about things that can help you during your wedding day and in the industry. So I've been photographing weddings since 2014 as a professional. So I photographed more than 100 events until now. And I want to start this presentation with a small chat about WedTrotter project. I will change screens now so you can see what I'm talking about. This project is made for you to get more experience and to see how top wedding photographers will photograph a wedding in real conditions, like real bride and groom, real moments, and they will show you exactly what they are doing in the wedding day. It's nothing like a workshop. It will be more like a one-on-one tutoring session. But enough about that. We'll get straight to the point. We'll talk about this a little bit later in this podcast. So I'm gonna start explaining you my my experience with wedding industry. So I'm gonna start with phases of a wedding, and the first phase. Actually, I will try to enumerate them all together. You can divide them by in two categories. They will be like engagement photo shoot, the preparations, the civil ceremony, the religious ceremony, and the party. I will go through all of these sections and give you tips and tricks about how I deal with different problems, how I will get nice pictures from the wedding day. So I will start with the engagement photo shoot. Why am I encouraging photographers to do this is because you will get to know the couple, and the couple will get to know you. And you can start make a connection, and you'll see what they like in terms of photography. As well, you'll learn how to interact with them and how to get the most out of them. And you'll get a feeling about how it's gonna be during the wedding day. So these are some photos about from engagement photo shoot that I did a couple of weeks ago. It was a nice experience. I got to know their feelings and what they want from me in their wedding day. So that's a big plus. So I already have an advantage that I know my clients and I know what they like. The next phase is the wedding day. So I will start with the preps, the brides, the preparation of the brides, and I will start with the bride's makeup session. This will be like the first moment when you get there, even if it's in a studio or it's at the bride's house, you will. This is the first moment that you'll interact with the bride and all the family and the people involved in this. So I'm gonna give you a few advices about this, and what am I doing in this part of the day. So try to get beyond the usual stuff. You will have like plenty of time to think the frames and to get the most creative ones. Usually the makeup session lasts like for 1 hour at least, and you will have time to pay attention at the bride, like making faces or interacting with people in the room, and you can compose beautiful images. This is a shot that I took at the bride's house. And this is like the bridesmaids interacting when the bride was having her makeup done as well. Just a little moment captured in the makeup session day. So after this, after the makeup, it's like the day will go with the preparations of the bride. You have to photograph, first of all, what I do is photograph the dress, the accessories, and I'm looking for the moment to happen, because they will happen. Even if it's a smile, a tear, a hug, because the pressure is like really huge at that point of the day. The bride is going to get married, and this is a very important time for her and for the family as well. And it's a lot of tension in the air, and you have to get that in the camera. And to do that, you need to pay attention to every single detail. Try to eliminate from the background any object that is a distraction, a flower, a painting. It's simpler to take it away physically than to do it afterwards in Photoshop, because you will have time. It will be no rush at this point of the day, so you'll be fine with that. For the portraits, if the light is bad in the room or the room is not very nice, go near a window or make your exposure for the highlights, like I did this in this picture. And the light coming from the window will act like a softbox. Try not to make only static portraits. Add some movement in your frames, because that will create a dynamic moment. And static portraits are not that they're not that so communicative with the feelings. They are not full of feelings. So if you have emotion in your and the movement in your frame, it will be more of a powerful photography. So here are a few examples how I did that. I always try to do reflections and to get interesting composing in my photography, or get the bride to pose naturally, not looking at the camera. These are a few of my accessory shots. And this is a moment with the bridesmaids. So it's real moments. These photos are like the most powerful, and the bride loves them. If you provide her this kind of photos with the interesting composing and meaningful moments, she will be happy, and her family as well. Okay, here is the bride with the dress. If you have any questions, please feel free to. Actually, I did a thing here, and I need to share my screen. Okay, so actually, I didn't see any of my pictures. Okay, now you will. You will see what I'm seeing. I thought you will see what I'm seeing on the screen. So basically now you should see what I'm seeing. Excuse me for this, but this is my first webinar, so be gentle with me. Okay, so go here in full screen mode. Okay, so now you will see what I'm seeing. So that will be okay. I will go past the few shots that I've done that I spoke about. So here are the engagement shots. Here are the preparation shots with the bride. Actually, these photos are taken when we were filming the pilot episode for the WedTrotter. So you'll get to see how everything was done here when we will release the pilot episode at the beginning of next year. So through the photos I got about right here. So okay, these are the bridesmaids, the detailed shots that I spoke about, the bride with the dress as well, accessories, dress as well, bride with the bridesmaid. Okay, so I got to the wedding day, the preparation of the groom. There are almost all the advices that I gave for the bride as well, for the bride preparation as well. It's photograph the groom's accessories, the groom with the boys, the groom with the parents, and try to catch candid shots. This is a shot that I really love. It was a kid there in the room, and he was so afraid of all the agitation there and the excitement, and I got this look of him. It's like really nice. This is the groom's portrait. This is a creative one when he was having his hair done. Everything was happening at the bride and the groom's house, so I didn't need to change locations. This is like candy shot with his mother as well. After the groom shot, the groom preparations, I will, it is the first look, the here is simple, the first look when the groom meets the bride. If they have not chosen a place yet, you can interfere and recommend them where is the best meeting point, just to make a composing frame at the base of a stair, outside, in the garden, in the swimming pool, you name it. So just be sure you make a wise choice depending on your lighting, space, and background. Do not forget to get a kiss. Maybe you are tired photographing kisses, but for the couple, it's really important. It's the first kiss when they are dressed like a bride and a groom, and they will want to keep that as a memory. So be sure you make a photo of it. If there are any traditions, be aware of any of them that are respected during the preparation. Here in Romania, there are loads of them, and it can be different from one region to another. This is the meeting moment when the bride came from the stairs and saw the groom. And this was like a really nice and elegant moment that I captured. And if you see this frame, I composed it to have the reflection and to have the bride's face in the frame as well. You can't see it properly, but the moment it's so powerful that this doesn't matter that much at this point. After this moment, I'm trying to get a few portrait shots with them, because this is a proper time and they have the real enthusiast, and they measure one another with their eyes. So it's like a really nice moment to have their portraits done together. The second moment of the wedding day, it will be here in Romania. It will be the civil ceremony. Before the civil ceremony happens, make sure you get some greetings, because they will meet new family members that didn't were at their home. and friends, and everybody will greet anyone, and they will be very happy about it. If you have any time there, use it for a small photo shoot. I did this frame before the civil ceremony. The civil ceremony delayed for about 15 minutes. So I just crossed the road and see this frame in my head, and just told them to go on the stairs and tell them to walk towards me. And this is how I caught this frame. I was lucky enough to get the pigeons in the frame as well. So it's a nice frame, I think. During the civil ceremony, focus on the couple and the close family members. You already met them, so you know who is important for them. And make sure you get that frames as well. These are some of the greetings after they sign the papers. I will go to the next phase. It's the wedding day, the short photo shoot during the wedding day. What I recommend in this situation is to pick a good location for you, close enough to the venue, not to lose too much time with the travel from one location to another. Maybe it will be your best chance to get some really nice pictures with both of them in a really nice place that you picked. So make sure you pick a good location that is nice for you. At this time of the day, the sun was preparing to go down, so it was the sunset. So I had a really nice lighting. This frame, what I really love about it is the gold light behind them. It looks like the forest is on fire. So I had the luck with this as well. And this is like a really cute moment. You can see the love in their eyes, and I got it on camera. They're not really sophisticated pictures. They focus on the moments and the looks, the looks and the feelings of the bride and the groom. Usually at this point of the day it will come the religious ceremony, but in this case with this wedding the religious ceremony was before the short photo shoot. What I recommend about this, here is very important not to miss any big moments like the vows, when they put the rings on their hand, a tear of the bride, the look of the parents. Most of the churches are pretty dark, so make sure you use some flashes or bump up your ISO without affecting the quality of the pictures. Take some patience with you, because most of the ceremonies will last like an hour, so you'll have time to get shots from all the angles you want and all perspectives. And this is a shot when the bride's veil was lifted. So I got movement in the frame, which is really important for me, because in my early days of photographing, my photography was really static, which was a minus for me. If you look at the church, it was under construction, so it doesn't look really nice, but it creates a texture. So I wanted them to remember their day, the way it was. So when they will look after 10 years of at this photography, they will laugh, and it was their wedding day, so they will remember it as it is. Here the bride was was crying a little bit, and if you see the look of the groom, he's like really nice looking. He has a really nice looking at her. This is before entering the church, when the veil was put to the bride's head. And these are some portraits as well. Moments between the ceremony, kids. And this is the exit of the exit from the church. It's pretty important too, and nice to photograph. The participants will throw rice, flowers, confetti. We release pigeons and lots more. That this will be one of the chances that you can get some more dynamic shots, and you'll get nice expressions like these guys. And these guys around here, they were pretty funny. Okay, this is the entering of the church. Rings as well. I already told you about not to miss any of this. You can get really creative in the church, because like in the makeup session of the bride, you'll have 1 hour and you get to know your location, and you can you will know where the light will go on the couple, and you can get really creative. Just don't stay in one place. Move a lot. Go upstairs where the chorus is. Climb a wall. Go under a seat. Whatever will make you do something different, because you don't want to your photographs look like another like something that have been done. I know it's pretty challenging to do something different, but do your best to do that. It's really important. It's really important to do that. Okay, I'm just gonna check to see if my connection is still good. So okay, you still see me? So I'll go back to the slides and continue with the moments of the day. The party. The party usually starts with the entering of the bride and the groom in the venue. This party location was located outside of the city, so it was a garden actually. We were having a nice weather there, and I tried to get elements that will make them remember this day, because this is not like a usual location for weddings in Romania. This was the first time when this location had a wedding. It is a roses garden outside the Arad city. It was like 30 kilometers away. A really nice place. It was pretty late it was actually 10th of July this wedding was shot, and the flowers weren't that colorful. The bride and the groom told me that it was raining a lot a few days earlier, and the colors and the flowers got a little bit broken. I don't know if this is the proper word, but this is what I have in mind now. Try to get candid moments, and try to catch joy and happiness on people's faces, because this is the pictures that the bride and the groom will like to see in their album, and to remember this day like a really happy day of their lives, no matter the tension and the pressure organizing this kind of event. This is a frame from the cutting of the cake. It's not really chronological, but I will explain it. I will explain it to you. So I will go to the first dance. Take wide shots, close-ups. Be careful at the smoke because if it will get up in the air, it will be pretty hard to make an accurate focus. So make sure you get close enough. This actually was really a lucky frame for me, which I really love, because the focus point was on their faces. But because of the smoke, I use the focus system. I put my camera on eye focus all the time, and that makes the camera change the focus point to the first object that came in front of the lenses. So when I put my focus point on their faces, because of the smoke it was a bad contrast on their faces, the focus point moved on their hands. But this was a lucky shot that I got, but I really love it. And this is another frame from their first dance. And be careful at fireworks as well, because you will need to change exposures very quickly with about 5 or 6 stops. A really important advice that I want to give to you is before the dance, talk with the venue vendor. Tell him what the best light will be for you, and if he has some LED lights, or some venues have that as a background lighting, tell them not to focus any LED lights on the couple. It is horrible. They should actually be banned. But actually, it's very cheap, and the venues will try to use that because they won't consume too much power. On the dancing floor, take a wide lens. I usually use 16-35. From my experience, this is the best lens to use on the dance floor, because it is very crowded over there, and sometimes if you have a 50 millimeter zone or I know a 70-200, it's no point using it on the dance floor. Do not be afraid to get close to the subject. They will see the camera, and they would love to show you their moves on the dance floor. And you just need to be patient, and you'll be ready to frame it. Be prepared for all the wild things over there. Okay, the cake cutting practically equals with the end of the party, but focus on the couple expressions. Maybe you will catch a cake fight. It didn't happen at this wedding, but I did get some nice shots as well. And actually, this is a really nice picture that I really love. It's a really emotional, and this is I'm gonna tell you the story of this picture. The guy hugging the bride is a singer from Scotland, and they were having a city break there, and they heard him singing on the streets. And since their wedding day was closing up and was getting close, and they didn't book a band. They did eventually afterwards, but at that point they didn't book any band. They asked him to sing at their wedding. So this was happening at the end of the party, and this is the way that bride was thanking him for accepting to come to Romania from there, like they were completely strangers at that point, and sing for them. He was singing like really, really good with that English Scottish accent, but was really, really nice music that he sang at the party. Okay, So now we were going to move to planning for a photo shoot. There are loads of things to say here, but I'm gonna tell you the things that I'm doing to have a happy photo shoot and to get some of the pictures that I really, really love. No matter if you plan the photo shoot during the wedding day or for the dress session, you will need to follow these simple steps that will make the job easier for you. At least for me, they did. So, location. This is the magic word. The location can offer you great background or surroundings that can help you achieve your goal. It is not important if it's a castle, a top of a mountain, a park, or a cityscape. Be sure that this is what the couple wanted. Beforehand, you can make any recommendations. Ask the bride and the groom what would they like, natural or urban, romantic or playful photo session. You are in authority to provide them info about what is most suitable, and make sure that it suits you and it suits them. What I'm talking about recommendations of the location here. There is no point to climb, let's say, Mount Everest if the couple loves a trip with a boat in the Pacific Ocean. So you got the point now. If the photo session takes place in the wedding day, you don't have time to travel. So your choices are pretty much limited, but you still have, for nature lovers, you can start with parks. Hopefully they won't be crowded because in the weekends people tend to go out a lot. And for urban shots lovers, well, it won't be any problem if the wedding takes place in a city. So after the location is set, you can go down to the available time for the photo shoot. During the wedding day, usually you can get off with 1 hour at most, but for the dress sessions, like in this case with these pictures, it will take almost a day, including the travel. So if you don't agree going on Seychelles Islands for an exotic one, in an exotic trip, actually find the most nice place that's close to you. That will take you only 1 day for the photo shoot. But I think you don't mind going to Seychelles. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the camera and gear point here. Make sure you have extra memory cards, extra batteries, and all the available gear that you would like to use. If you're not shooting with available light and you are a strobist, you will need at least a flash, maybe some gels, video lamp, extra batteries for the flashes. Do not forget about a blend or a snoot or whatever you need. I'm not a strobist myself, so I try to keep it very simple and not to get loads of equipment with me. So I hardly use one flash and only when needed. As the couple, if they are interested in a thematic photo shoot, like in this case, I recommended them some smoke fireworks. Maybe they will want balloons, ice cream, Hello Kitty, whatever. Make sure if they want that, they will be prepared to have it. And document yourself a bit about what they want in their photos. Ask fellow photographers if they did that before and if they have any recommendation. So at this frame, I'm gonna tell you a story about it. I was shooting, this couple wanted some smoke fireworks. So I was shooting there, this is the Hunedoara Castle. And I thought these fireworks will last for like 2-3 minutes, but it wasn't like the things that I thought, and they were lasting like for 30 seconds actually. And I wish that I knew that before I was start shooting, so I can plan the shoot a little in depth. I managed with it, but I got away with these funny frames. It is a funny story about this couple, because the groom wanted all the playful shots, and the bride wanted the romantic ones and like these ones. So I was trying to get them both happy with these kind of frames. Okay. So during the photo shoot, do not forget to take small breaks. Maybe you will, maybe you won't notice because of the adrenaline, but do not push the couple too much. They are not professional models, and at a photo shoot could be really exhausting for them. Take a meal break if needed, but I recommend you to have in your bag some extra snacks or protein bars or whatever. The couple will thank you for that. Another advice that I want to give to you is make it fun and make it easy. Most of the couples appreciate the experience with you as a photographer as much as they appreciate the photos you took. So don't make it boring or too exhausting. They will remember it like a great experience and not like a wedding photo shoot. When you go home, make sure you post some previews about the treasure dress session. But I think you already know that the couple will love to have a fast sneak peek about your work and their family as well. So I'm gonna go now to the section. Actually, it's great photos in different conditions. My advice is for that is get a waterproof camera and lenses. I use the D-Mark III and the L lenses from Canon. You don't have to use this. You can use whatever gear you want, but this is what works best for me. If you do not afford that, take a cover for your camera and lenses. And if you, for some reason, you forget at home, take a bag, like a simple bag, a plastic bag, and a tape and DIY one on the spot. It's like really, really, really simple to do that. I did it a few times. Always use the hood, the sun hood on the lens. It prevents, if it's raining, it prevents the water drops to get on your lens and get dirty. And if the camera falls off for some reason, it will be a great shock absorbent. Another advice is always have an umbrella at hand. So have a strap. I use these straps with connections for two bodies, so you can have free hands to climb a tree, a mountain. I know, do something with your hands. If you have busy hands, if you want to climb a tree and you have your camera in your hand, it won't be really easy to do that. But with this kind of leather strap, it will be like pretty much easy. Use two bodies and two different focal length lenses. When it's raining and you are on top of a mountain where you need to focus on your safety, it's easier to grab the other body than to change lenses. So if the gear is secure, now you can focus on creativity. Everybody knows that how expensive the photo gear is. Okay, so I'm gonna talk a little bit more about how to obtain. I cannot believe you got that effect. is there are a few small advices that I want you to give here. So let's say I'm going to use this photo shoot as an example. Surprise them. They already know your portfolio. Do not provide them photos that you already took for another couple last Saturday. Just be creative, work with them, and find new ways to push yourself. This will make you a better photographer. Get out of your comfort zone, climb walls, I know, get on your knees, but only with an objective purpose, not just to look like you are really working. If you do that and the photos are blurry, your effort is like for nothing. Make experience. This is another advice that I'm giving you. Add small items to your camera bag that could add value to a photo, like a small prism, a mirror, a color gel, maybe duct tape, Christmas lights, whatever it's. It goes in your camera bag. You can use it in various ways and could get. You can get really nice photos from ordinary location as well. Get high. I told you, get high, get low, and perspective can improve a photography a lot. But most important, get dirty, work for it. Do not expect it to happen just because you press the shutter button. And do not photograph from your eye level. Actually, this one was photographed from an eye level, but it was a big distance between me and them, so that's why I get that shot. And try to make it funny for. I already told you that, but try to make it funny for you and for them as well. After we did this photo session, we went to a restaurant and we talked about how the day went. They were really, really happy with some of the previews that I showed them just straight from the camera. Okay. So if there are any questions, just write me at this email address. You can even go and write them here in the chat box. And let me just change screen now. So you have actually you can see me now. Yeah. You have here on your monitor on the right a section for the chat. So you can post any questions you want here, or you can send me an email at this address. I'm going to put it again here, Cătălin@WedTrotter.com. I will gladly answer any of your questions, no matter if they are technical questions or just a second to make. I'm really new at this, so just be patient with me. For the last moments, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the WedTrotter project. Why am I doing this? Actually, it all started. It's like I already put it on the Kickstarter's page, so I will highly appreciate your effort backing this project up. But I started this project because I wanted to be a better photographer. And how am I doing that? I was looking on, I was Googling it, and I was searching for real moments at the real weddings with real photographers, but I didn't find any info about it on the internet. So my thought was, why I shouldn't make one of these series? And I was lucky enough to know some great photographers, and I was so happy that they accepted the invitation to be part of this project. So they are top wedding photographers from around the globe. We have Marius Bărbulescu from Romania, I think all the Romanian photographers know him. We have Isabel Hatting from Holland, Segun Olutu from UK, but he's a Nigerian photographer. We have Citlali Rico from Mexico, Ken Park from USA, Kafalu from Canada, Vince Ivang from China, Christelle Roll from South Africa, Ufuk Sarisen from Turkey. So we get to know all the experience that this photographer have from their wedding. I will try to provide it to you. So for this, we will film them during their wedding day, how they photograph a wedding in their location with all the traditions that is happening there, with all the preparations of the of their camera bag, what lenses, what camera they are using, and what they will do in a stressed and tension condition over there. So it is a really nice project that I believe in, and I hope you like it, the idea. You can find the trailer on the Kickstarter's page. You can have a look you can have a look at it, and you can always provide feedback. I will highly appreciate your feedback about it. What would you like to see in these episodes? What answers you will like to? What questions you would like to get the answer to? Just write them on the on the email. I will put the contact form here again. Let me just change screens here. Okay. Just a second. Okay. So just write me any questions you want regarding WedTrotter project or regarding photography. I will happily answer. And let's be WedTrotters, okay? And most of all, most of it, and most of all things, I think this is the correct form, get out of the box, get out of your comfort zone. It will make you a better photographer. Okay, I know I wasn't that good at speaking, but thank you for thank you guys for watching me, and hopefully I will get to know you pretty much soon, and you will see the Kickstarter's project backed up, and I will provide you great infos about it. Thank you very much again. In a couple of hours, actually, I think in 2 hours I will be with Daniel Kindea and Marius Bărbulescu at Radio Pătrățele. I already put this on the my Facebook page. I put the link over there, so you can hear more info about the WedTrotter project in this podcast. Thank you guys again, and see you soon as always. Take care.